Hello, nature enthusiasts. Today, we're diving deep into the mysterious and fascinating world of underwater creatures. Black swallower. The elongated intestine that is linked to the belly of the black swallower fish allows it to swallow prey that is much larger than itself. Given that black swallowers inhabit the deep ocean and that food can be in short supply there, this adaptation is very helpful. Join us in this exciting journey of exploration and understanding. Hit that subscribe button now and let's continue unraveling the mysteries of the deep together. Venus Flytrap Anemone. Found in the Gulf of Mexico.
Yeah, these anemones are Venus Flytrap Anemones. You can see why they got their name. Wow.
Sea anemones are related to jellyfish and are named after the flower of the same name. Specifically, this creature closes its tentacles to either catch prey or elude predators. Obese Dragonfish. That is not polite. To be honest, though, the fat dragonfish won't be offended by its name. After all, it's not a bad thing to be one of the biggest species in the Melanostomiidae family. It's really very badass, in fact. These deep-water inhabitants, according to the Australian Museum, have a smooth, scaleless black body, a long chin barbel, a full set of enormous fang-like teeth, and a sequence of light-producing photophores down the body and behind both eyes. These guys inhabit the waters surrounding Australia the most of the time, although they are also found in the Atlantic, Indian, and Pacific Oceans. Terrible Claw Lobster. This new species of blind lobster, named Dinochelys ausubale for its terrible or fearful, dinos in Greek, claws, chela, joins an extremely exclusive group of cousins in the genus Thaumastocalopsis. Prior to this, two species and just four other individuals had been discovered, both in Australia. The specimen was gathered in 2007 during the Aurora mission, which was coordinated by the Philippines Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources, the Natural History Museums of France and the United States. Additionally noteworthy is the second component of the name, ausubale, which honors Jesse Ausubel, one of the co-founders of the Census of Marine Life. Goblin Shark. In summary, goblin sharks appear quite menacing. The extremely unusual animal may reach a maximum length of 15 feet and can catch prey by projecting its entire jaw outward. The likelihood of seeing a goblin shark is low. Since 1898, less than 50 have been observed. Coffinfish. These deep-water fish, sometimes referred to as the sea toad, are related to frogfish. These animals have a little lure that sticks out of the hollow behind their eyes. Because there is so little light at the depths where coffinfish live, they can swiftly attack by using it to entice food towards them. These fish also boast such sizable gills that they can increase their body volume by up to 30% upon inhaling a significant quantity of water, according to Smithsonian Magazine. It's not precisely feasible for a human to expand their lungs to the size of their entire abdomen, as that would be the equivalent. Gulper eel. The gulper eel, also referred to as the pelican eel, is named for its massive mouth and jaw, which helps them to swallow prey whole. They can grow up to 6 feet in length, and their huge mouths allow them to hunt down meals that are larger than them. This usually happens when food is scarce. It's believed that gulper eels usually eat crustaceans and other small marine animals. Due to the way its fins resemble ears, this grimpatoothous octopus, which is found across the mid-Atlantic ridge, is referred to as Dumbo with affection. The Dumbo octopus, which may be found living at least 4,000 meters below the surface and frequently far lower, is recognized as the deepest dwelling octopus species. Owing to their innate rarity, these octopuses have evolved distinctive mating practices to enhance their chances of procreating. For instance, after mating, The females can retain sperm in their bodies for extended periods of time and carry eggs at different stages of development. How would you react if one of these creatures appeared in front of you, especially in the eerie depths of the ocean where you can barely see your hands? Please share your thoughts in the comments, and let's discuss your feelings. Join Knowledge Nectar.